I'm Emma Pasarow, and I'm in the new Netflix film, Along for the Ride, based on the novel by Sarah Dessen. Today, I'm going to read the book to get in a cozy mood, so sit back and enjoy. At the end of the pier, we said our goodbyes, and they headed back to the car. I could hear them still talking as I turned and started in the other direction, back to the gas grow, where I was the only customer as I filled up a fresh cup. The cashier, an older woman with blonde hair and a name tag that said Wanda, was working on a crossword. She put it down, then rang me up while stifling a yawn. Earlier that night, I'd taken off to be alone, only to find, to my surprise, that company was just what I needed. Still, I knew it must have been hard for Maggie to come looking for me, not knowing how I'd react when I saw her. The easiest thing would have been to just leave me alone, but she didn't go for the easiest thing. I was a girl who liked a challenge too, or at least, I liked to think of myself that way. So, I went looking for Eli. The bar still had an hour or so left until closing, with people and music spilling out their open doors. Farther down into the business district, though, all the stores were dark. But in the bike shop, way in the back, a light was on. I saw someone move across the lit, open back door of the shop. Dark hair, blue shirt. Before I knew what I was doing, my hand was wrapping the glass hard. Eli looked up, his face wary. When he came closer and saw it was me, he didn't really look relieved. Or surprised, actually. "Let me guess," he said. "You want to learn to ride a bike, and it can't wait until morning." "No," I said. He dropped his hand from the door and just stood there looking at me. I realized he was waiting for me to explain myself. I stepped through the door and he shut it, locking it behind me. "So," he said, picking up an envelope and glancing at it, "you say you're not here for a bike." "No," I said. "Then what? You're just out walking the boardwalk in the middle of the night? I thought you might want to talk or something." Eli shut the drawer slowly and looked at me. "Talk," he said, his voice flat. "Yeah." He was just sitting there, staring at me, expressionless. "You're up, I'm up, I just figured..." "Oh, I get it," he said, nodding. "Right. You know now." "No," I said. He shook his head. "I should have known when I saw you at the door, not to mention at the party. Maggie isn't exactly known for holding back information." I just sat there, not sure what to do. I said, "Look, I'm sorry, I just thought..." "I know what you thought." He picked up a stack of papers, rifling through it. "I appreciate you wanting to help me or whatever, but I don't need it, okay?" I nodded numbly. I remembered how that first night I'd thought of him as haunted before I even knew this was true. He said, "Do you want to know why I talked to you?" "Yeah," I said, "I do." "Because," he said, "from the first day on the boardwalk, you were different. You never tiptoed around me or acted all weird and sorry for me or gave me that look." "What look?" "That one," he said, pointing at my face. I felt myself blush. "You were just normal until tonight."
Thank you so much for joining me. Make sure to watch Along for the Ride now on Netflix.